want to hear from you. I like to throw out a word and I want to hear your honest reaction when you hear that word. You ready for it? Rat. What do you think of? What do you think of when you hear that word rat? Maybe some good things, maybe a little some bad things. Sometimes they get a negative reaction, right? Some people, what do you think of, hon? Do you think of food? Okay. Well, I'm going to direct your attention over here, and hopefully if you feel negative about rats, we're going to change your mind today. We're going to meet Miss Violet here. We're going to look right up at the top of the hot bar. You can see her little nose sticking out, and we'll see what Violet is going to do for us today. Going to take her time. She's looking at all the surroundings, all the smells and sights and sounds. Right here. There she goes. Oh, she might come back. Here she comes. So, you can see her moving really, really quickly across that rope. Now, who's done a maze before? Maybe you've done it on paper or in person. You've done maybe a corn maze in the fall. A lot of dead ends, right? You see Violet, she's really, really smart. She's not hesitating on those dead ends. Super flexible, so she remembers how to go, and she's really good at bending on the different curves. She's going to take a dramatic pause here for her final descent. So you see, really, really smart, really good memory. She's pausing. She likes to build up the anticipation here. But when she comes out, this is the newest part of her training, so let's see if she gets it on the first try. But here at the Philadelphia Zoo, we're always talking about how to save energy helps to save wildlife and how easy it is to do. So we've taught Violet here to show us how easy it is to turn off our light. So if a rat can do it, we can certainly do it. She's got to use her full body weight and we're waiting for that click. You can see she takes her job really, really, there she goes. Skip the bottles, but that's okay. You can give her a round of applause. She did really well. So this is her training. This is almost like rat school for her. But it's a really awesome part of her day because she loves to show off how smart she is. And she's getting rewarded. We call this positive reinforcement. So right now she's in her carrier and she's getting a special treat for doing such an awesome job. What do you think she's eating?
Cheese.
Maybe cheese. We think of cheese when we think of rats. Our rats actually love corn. So Miss Violet is eating corn right now. She absolutely loves it. Who wants to see her go again? Did you guys think she was going to fall the first time you saw her? Were you nervous? Why didn't she fall off the rope? You saw a fascia moved across it, right? Why didn't she fall? What body parts is she moving to stay up on that rope? What do you think, boys and girls? Yeah. Her tail. Absolutely. That's very, very smart of you. So watch her tail this time. Now she's using those claws to stay on the rope, but you're absolutely right. She uses that tail to help her balance, just like if we're walking across a balance beam and our arms kind of go out. You know how we do that? The same thing that works with the tail. It helps her balance, so it's moving back and forth to keep her up there. Now she's moving really, really fast through the maze this time. Now I said she's super duper flexible, and she's also using her sense of smell. So she's using that really good sense of smell to smell her path from where she went before. And she's also using another body part. What are these, boys and girls? What are these? Whiskers. Yeah, she's using her whiskers to feel the sides of the maze. Pretty awesome. So let's see. She gets her light on the first try. She's pausing. She knows I have to stop and do something here. One leg out. Here she comes. All right, so this part is sort of like station training. So she knows I gotta stop here, perfect, and do something. And up into her rope and into her carrier. She loves being there. So we're gonna do, I think, one more time, because practice always makes us a little bit better. So every single time Violet goes through, she's getting a little bit smarter. Pretty awesome. Do you guys practice anything at home? Maybe you do sports, or maybe you like math, so you always practice that. Same thing works with our animals, is we're asking them to do something. Here she comes. See, using that tail. Moving back and forth really fast down her ladder. Now, everything you see here was done in small steps, so she didn't learn everything all at once, just like we do in school. We don't learn everything on the first day. Same thing with Violet. We taught her all these different things. The practice makes us a little bit better. So she learned to use the rope first and then the maze. We're going to try it one more time. She didn't go through the maze. Here we go. She's got to make it dramatic, doesn't she? There she goes. So you see, really using that flexibility. Really good. Feeling with those whiskers, using that nose to smell. Dramatic pause before the final descent. Here she goes. And right through. See her little face sticking out.
She's probably catching her breath. That was a fast run through that maze. Right, let's see. Good girl, she got on the first try. Excellent, let's give her a round of applause. Fantastic. So hopefully if you guys feel a little icky when you hear rats or you think about rats, you've changed your mind because we think they're pretty awesome here. Now, if you guys have any questions, this is a really good opportunity to talk to some of the keepers and some of the trainers that work with our animals here.
Thank you.